Hello, this is Nadine Hanwell on the Beatrix Potter Trail. I'm standing very close to Bolton Gardens in London, where Beatrix Potter was brought up. She lived a typical middle-class Victorian life and lived with her mother and father, Helen and Rupert, and her younger brother, Bertram, who was actually 6 years younger. They got on very well, and it's a good job because Bertram and Beatrix spent a lot of their life when they were young on the third floor, in the nursery that became the schoolroom. It was a good job, really, that they had each other, and also they had a love of animals and drawing. And they used to sneak in rabbits and mice, one called Hunca Munca, hedgehog, she had a pet hedgehog, Tiggy, a bat, and many other things. And we have the animals to thank for what Beatrix Potter did later on. She had a difficult time with her mother, not a very good relationship, and she wasn't allowed to go out and about. And here, many years later, is a letter she wrote to Norman Warne, her publisher, telling a little more about her mother. Dear Mr. Warne, I was very much perplexed about the doll's house. I would have gone gladly to draw it, and I shall be so very sorry if Mrs. Warne or you thought me uncivil. I did not think I could manage to go to Surbiton without staying to lunch. I hardly ever go out, and my mother is so exacting, I had not enough spirit to say anything about it. I have felt vexed with myself ever since, but I did not know what to do. It does wear a person out. And then Norman obviously invited the mother as well, and this was the reply from Beatrix. Dear Mr. Wall, I don't think that my mother would be very likely to want to go to Surbiton. You do not understand what I meant by exacting. People who only see her casually do not know how disagreeable she can be when she takes dislikes. I should have been glad to go. Poor Beatrix. That's all for now. Bye.